everyone. Welcome back.
Hey, everybody. Take two.
Take two. I didn't press record on the last session we just completed. And
it was a really good one, though, I have to say.
Oh, we're talking about resilience, by the way. Elements on air, number 8.
We didn't go into this last time, but I think there needs to be humor in resilience.
Oh my God, yeah, it's huge. Human resilience. We're breaking down all the parts of resilience that not just being flexible, but there's also agility. And so this is part 2 of 3. And we've been teaching this on our teacher training and in workshops as well. And we were given an amazing example of real life opportunity to relearn flexibility.
What would that be?
So our lease expired at the end of March, and so we had to exit our apartment. We had to move all of our belongings.
In the midst of doing teacher trainings and these online classes now, which I have to say, they take a little more bandwidth and time out of our lives, for the fact that it becomes more of a production thing instead of Kendall or Monica showing up and turning the heating system on and like, okay, let's teach class.
Yeah, the opportunities to learn flexibility are enormous. The learning curve, the ability to pivot from one thing to the other. It's, you know, one thing that this worldwide situation is opportunities creating for everybody to learn or relearn.
And what does moving in the midst of a pandemic sound like?
So we didn't hire movers to do any of the work because obvious reasons. And so Kendall, with super strength, he carried all the heavy lifting.
Every sofa, every TV, every bed, every mattress. And Monica did all the detailed packing, which...
Organizing, cleaning, all the stuff that's got to get done. What was so challenging in this idea of being flexible is that we didn't know how this was going to come down. Like, we had the thought, okay, so we have to move.
How we're going to weave it into everything that we have going on, still keep classes going.
And also... is it even a possibility to do it between two people in the time constraints that we had? You know, how are we going to pull this off?
I didn't know if it was going to be possible. I just know we had to keep moving forward.
Ha. We just know that. Well, that's part one of being flexible. Just going to the definition, right? Flexibility is the ability to bend without breaking. And everybody's got this idea that yoga is just about flexibility. Well, it's one of its components, and we do train flexibility in the body, and so...
But where else do we train it?
In our minds.
It's a two-part thing that is connected together. Are we flexible in our bodies? Maybe. Are we flexible in our minds? And does the flexibility in the mind help the flexibility in the body?
Maybe. At least from my experience, I know that if I pick my destination, right, and I want my destination to look a certain way, say move in 2 days, 3 days, and have everything perfect by the end of it, and I
hold... Does that ever really happen?
No, that doesn't happen. But if I hold on too strong to that limiting belief, what ends up happening is causes a lot of suffering along the way because I feel that I'm not getting there as fast as I need to be getting to that point.
And I think me walking into this, I'm like, physically, I don't know if I can do this because it is a lot of furniture in our place and lots of stuff to carry. And if I hold on to the belief that I can or that's not possible or that the universe won't support us and get us there somehow, then I become too rigid and I think I already know the outcome before anything's even happened.
That's a good point. I don't think we thought we touched on that, that already knowing the outcome, right? Because as we start to create that reality from the point that we get anxious because we're not getting the results we need when we want them.
It doesn't look the way we think it should happen.
We start creating from that perspective, right? And so then the outcome may turn out to be that.
And we become rigid because we're not flexible in how things will work or how they're going to come together. For instance, in all this, I'm thinking I'm literally going to have to pick the sofa and stuff up by myself, which I've done before in separate days, not all in one day when I've been moving. But in the midst of all this, this appliance dolly that has these huge straps on it appeared out of nowhere, and I'm so grateful it did because I don't think I would have been able to do it. But with this dolly, I was able to wheel everything out of the house, all the big stuff, all the boxes, and everything.
We are also figuring out what the next step is for the elements, where are we going with the elements. And so not only are we experiencing a little bit of shifting in our personal lives, but it is a big shift for the business side. And for most people, the idea of both happening simultaneously, it would be debilitating. It would be beyond chaotic for the energy that we carry. And we know that if we are imbalanced energetically, we're also prone to more of a disease. We're become our immunities and our stress levels, inflammation starts to attack our bodies.
And a lot of it starts in here. We think that flexibility is, oh, just being able to bend over and touch my toes in class, but is a restriction in your flexibility that physically happens in your body, is that attached to your mind?
Yes. So talking about people that are going under surgery, general anesthesia, the moment that the mind is shut off,
their range of motion increases. Their flexibility increases because our mind restricts things to what protect us and keep us alive. I don't know if you've ever had an injury, which I know you have, and I have too, and every time I have an injury, like I will stop myself before going to a posture because of, and it's almost automatic because I don't want to re-injure myself. And same thing if you're fearful about going into like a inversion, it's like you'll see the hips come to here, and it's not the body that's stopping, it's the mind that's cutting the hips from going any higher because of what might happen.
Yeah, so kinesthetically, we apply those principles on our mats, we move, we learn, we start teaching range of motion and flexibility, but the restriction is more about the perspective, what is possible. What typically in yoga, if we try to force our minds into what we think the posture should look like, despite that our bone structure might be different from the person next to us, that you know we have different habits, that we have a different mind.
Different habits, we have different shapes of our muscles, different flexibility in them, different shapes of our bones, different proportions. And so if we try to enter something, a posture the same way somebody else is, it may not be our truth. And then we're trying to be them and not us. And because we are all look very similar, but we're all very different, we have to find our own truth as we move through it and what our bodies can do and can't do.
I know that when I've been so limiting into my idea of how this is supposed to be going, the result of that tends to be an injury. And it tends to be an injury on and off the mat at both, and the outward expression and then the little microcosm of yoga. And so what we're doing in our movement or practice is trying to connect the dots. How is me being flexible in my body is going to reflect so that I can be more peaceful about the ever-changing world?
Being more flexible in our mind.
Yeah, does it ever stop, Kendall?
I'm just going to say no from the beginning here. It's like, the only time it stops is when you stop. You know, if you're training for a marathon and you run a 5K, it feels what a 5K feels like. You're still running the same depth of that path as you go up to 26.2 miles, but you have no idea the experiences and stuff that are down that same path for you, that what it will feel like then. And so we just keep having these, we keep digging deeper and deeper down our path, getting more deeper experiences and opportunities in front of us. We're like, oh, we think we mastered this. We get to a 10K, we feel great, right? Like, nice work. And it's like, oh, am I still going for the 26K or do I stop here? And the thing is, life doesn't stop.
Mm-mm. No, we
and
just...
And so these experiences, they don't stop. They just become bigger opportunities as we walk through our lives.
I don't want any more opportunities.
I look at it as we're graduating. We graduate each opportunity, we get a diploma for it, and then we're off to the next one, right? Just like going to college. It's a different experience down the same path as you hone in and hone in and hone in more.
What our aim is to continue these conversations to give you tools, change perspective. The situation that we're all in is temporary. And just as about you're about to get comfortable, we're about to get comfortable with the situation we're in, it's about to change again. And so the flexibility demands our pressing attention to be able to move with the times and to be able to be flexible about how we think around them.
And before this coronavirus came into play, I had just gotten comfortable with the studio, the business part of it, and watching the machine go and all that stuff. And I was like, ah, and at that moment, everything changed. Like, okay, here we are again, you know. And it's like, you know, and the reason that we're going over this is because life is asking all of us to be resilient and to be more flexible. And and I know that in everyone's lives there are a lot of unknowns, and there is a lot of crazy things going on,
a lot of people suffering,
and so we want to give tools like being flexible, not just in the body, but in the mind, that will help everybody on the path as we transverse this virus.
We feel with you. We are with you.
Traverse. There you go.
We are with you. We are feeling with you. And we hope that you're well, that we hope that that you find joy in every moment that you're experiencing, and then maybe light someone else's candle along the way.
I want to light your candle.
Aww, thank you, my candle. We love you, and wait next week, actually this week, because we're late this week with this release. We're talking about agility next.
I think we're early this week with the amount of work we got done. So I'm okay with that.
We love you guys, and we'll see you soon.
Namaste.